Voters in the swing state of Florida eyeing the final presidential debate closely, both during the broadcast.
Thank God that we have a nominee such as Trump that has been able to stand up and say, no, I'm not going to take it.
And in the light of the next day.
And although I don't like Hillary or anything about her, she just is more qualified and you can't deny it.
Well, it's pretty clear you have one person who has a lot of experience as opposed to the other candidate, completely inexperienced.
I'd say the one thing you have over me is experience, but it's bad experience.
Trump stirring up controversy, claiming the election could be rigged if he doesn't win.
That you will absolutely accept the result of this election.
I will look at it at the time. I'm not looking at anything now. I'll look at it at the time.
It's pretty unusual for a candidate to suggest that they'll have to wait and see to decide whether the election outcome they're going to accept or not. And typically, it's not terribly helpful for the candidate. Most candidates want people to be confident in the system. That way, they'll turn out and vote.
Polls taken before the debate give Hillary a slight edge over Trump, though it's unclear whether the final debate had an impact on voters.
At this stage of the campaign, the third debate is often what we call bias confirmation, which is if you liked one candidate going in, you probably like that candidate at the end.
For some voters, the biggest impression came from the tone more than the substance.
It belittles the democratic process. It's a train wreck.
It was exciting, always fun to watch, kind of crazy, of course.
The candidates fighting for voters. 29 electoral votes are up for grabs from Florida. Joshua Plogle, The Associated Press, Boca Raton.